The 2024 release of SOLIDWORKS Visualize has come with a brand new appearance type, DSPBR. In this video, I'll be providing a quick overview of what are these new DSPBR appearances, how they're created, how to use them, and finally, how to treat your legacy appearances. So firstly, what are DSPBR appearances? DSPBR is Dassault Systèmes' version of a popular, visually based rendered material type. This has fast become the industry standard in visualization and CGI workflows, and widely used by Dassault Systèmes and other rendering solutions, such as 3D Experience CATIA, DeltaGen, and 3D Excite. The physically based rendering methodology is formed with five separate texture maps, with two different variants, one for metallic appearances, another for anything else, technically referred to as dielectric appearances. These five texture maps are broken down into the base, ambient occlusion, normal map. And depending on whether you have a metallic appearance or not, roughness and metallic, or glossiness and specular. Besides these five texture maps, the DSPBR appearance type supports 13 extra values, which can be altered to get the correct specified appearances. These fall into the categories of sheen, flakes, clear coat, emissions, and volume. Five different texture maps, 13 extra variants on top. Are these appearances simply too complicated to use? Well, the answer is no. Although this shows the full versatility of the appearance, not all the elements are suitable for all appearance types. Let's look at the full composition of a DSPBR appearance. For example, metallic appearance only incorporate the base elements. Wood uses the base, clear coat elements, to represent any waxed or veneered appearances on top of wood grain. Both glass and plastic appearances use the base elements and volume to ensure they can create transparency. Lights utilize the emissive section only. Textiles use both the base and sheen, with more complex appearance types such as car paints utilizing the base, flakes, and coatings. With the most common appearance types, we'll see only certain aspects of the material model. To enhance this ease of use further, Visualize comes with an updated cloud library of over 430 optimized appearances, all separated into functional categories. These can be downloaded individually or by bulk via right mouse click. If you're making your own custom appearances, then start with an existing appearance. This will ensure you have the correct parameters ready to edit. Any custom appearances you create can be saved to your library, which in turn can be shared amongst colleagues. Many of your older Visualize projects will contain appearances with the older appearance types. Upon opening within 2024, we ask for you to upgrade these appearances to the new format. If you choose no, it would preserve the appearance types and even allow you to alter the same parameters before in previous versions, noting the previous appearance as legacy appearances. If, however, you choose yes and update the appearance to the new 2024 format, this would change the existing appearances to the new model. Although this is best for longevity of projects, be prepared to spend some time initially tweaking and optimizing the appearances to bring back the original definition. If you're using multiple releases of Visualize, you may wish to have both the older and the new appearance in the same library. Now, Visualize can only specify a single appearance library for all versions of Visualize, so we need to combine the two different ones. We'd recommend by adding all the previous appearances to a subfolder within your appearance, perhaps with a prefix of 23. This will allow easy access to both appearance libraries in whichever version of the software you use. So there we have it, a quick overview of the Dassault Systèmes' physically based rendering appearance types. These new appearances offer better realism and versatility. Bring your cameras to life. For more content on SOLIDWORKS Visualize, head to solidsolutions.co.uk